Hello everyone, this is LG65, here at home, doing Noodles War, and this is my first official game review. I love crossovers, but unfortunately I found that the recent Mario and Sonic crossover stunk. But thankfully, we have the upcoming Super Smash Bros. Brawl hopefully scale away the pain that we left suffering with Nintendo's and Sega's most beloved mascots. Anyway, again, I love fighting games, and I love crossovers, so I really like the Marvel vs. Capcom series. Those games were very, very good. And now I focus my attention on the SNK vs. Capcom series of games, including one of my own, Capcom vs. SNK EO on the GameCube. But first, let's take a look at the past overview of the original game that made it to the arcade. Past overview. Capcom, as many know, has created Street Fighter II, the most popular fighting game in history of man. As everyone knew, you can play as 8 characters and go through the game leading up to M. Bison. And of course, SNK wanted to follow in their path, so they created a fighting game of their own. And that game series was King of Fighters. While Street Fighter boasted one-on-one action, King of Fighters is more team-based combat. It's still one-on-one a la Street Fighter, but it's basically a 3-on-3 matchup. And the team that knocks out all the other team's members is the victor. That's what the kind of game King of Fighters is. It was right then and there that Capcom and SNK collaborated to make a fighting game that will show the abilities of what both major fighting game franchises can do. Thus is the birth of a crossover game which has elements of both King of Fighters and Street Fighter combined. And this game is entitled Capcom vs. SNK Millennium Fight 2K.
Capcom vs. SNK Millennium Fight 2000.
The game featured a slew of characters from Street Fighter, King of Fighters, and Art of Fighting, and the Fatal Fury series of games, each belonging to Capcom and SNK respectively. This game was among fan favorites as they come. Use team-based combat a la King of Fighters, and still use Street Fighter characters as well as their favorites from SNK fighting games. There's one problem with this game. It had this ratio system in which they can only have up to 4 ratio points, and each character is assigned a certain number of ratio points, and you cannot go over 4. So that means their favorites were, when they try to make a team of your favorites, it wouldn't be possible. So, but still, the game was fun, it was awesome, and it was well enjoyed by many fighting games fans everywhere. Taking away everything that made the first game pretty bad, but still made it enjoyable, there came a second one that boasted more characters and a lot more moves, because in the previous game, there was 2 moves that used to co-op super attacks. Now this time, it has 6. And of course, like I said, this game has boasted 4 characters, and instead a year later after Millennium Fight. So, now, it's come to this. We shall take a look at Capcom vs. SNK 2. In America, it's called Mark of the Millennium, but in Japan, it's called
Capcom vs. SNK 2 Millionaire Fighting 2001.
This game boasted 4 characters,
6 groups to duke it out with, and the gameplay is much faster. And now you can pick a team of your favorites under the new ratio system. It's still 4 ratio points, but you can pick up to 3 characters It was your favorite, so you can distribute your team points evenly. One person of two, two of one, and you can also have a team of two, or even a team of one. This game really surpasses the first one a whole lot. This arcade hit was later ported to Dreamcast in Japan, and a couple months later, it was ported on the PlayStation 2 in Japan, North America, and Europe. 2 years later, an EO version was coming out for the GameCube, and I was really happy to wait for it to come out because I don't own a PlayStation 2 at the time, only a GameCube. EO at the time stood for easy operation, meaning pull off super attacks easily and still retain the same flow as the PlayStation 2 counterpart. But is it that bad? Well, that's what I'm about to find out.
Gameplay. This game uses the same engine as the original, so you'll know how to play it. But there are a few changes, but I'll get to those in a bit.
First are the similarities. You have your six regular groups to choose from the start. 40 some characters to choose from. You can pick up to three. In this case, I decided to choose only two, specifically for this review. And finally, divide up your ratio points. Then you're ready for the brawl of your life. You go through the tournament, leading all the way up to Osaka. Along the way, you may be stopped by Bison, the leader of the Shadow Law organization, or Geese Howard, of Fatal Fury fame. These sub-bosses will give you a challenge just before you go into the final match in Osaka. But if you did well after the final, then you might take on Akuma or Rugal. But note that after you beat them, you might not get the ending for each character. But if you did really well, you could take on Shinakuma or Ultimate Rugal. And then you get the true ending for each of the characters you picked. Now for the differences. As you saw on that last screen, you can pick one of two control schemes after you pick your group. You can choose GCism, or you can play like the arcade with ACism. I'll explain how the two of them work. GCism is a control scheme designed for the GameCube edition. Basically, it simplifies all the special moves into one stick, in this case, the C stick. Just pull it in any direction, and your character will perform the move that is marked by that direction. All the normal punching and kicking, as well as the groove tactics, are also reduced to one button. You now must press B to dodge or roll, X to power up, and A to perform a counter move. ACism, on the other hand, is just like the arcade. Perform the command of each special and super, and also all groove-specific tactics are two-button in a specific strength for each punch and kick. Despite the control additions, there is a slew of problems for each. Sometimes the C-stick will respond too sensitively and you'll not get the move you actually want. Well, sometimes if I want one move and instead I get another, like for example, you want a Shinryuken, but instead you get a Tatsumaki Senpukyaku. And also, the beginners will easily get cheap wins under this new system. ACism also has its problems. The GameCube controller is not designed to be an arcade controller, so it'll be very hard to pull off supers and specials alike. Another problem that both control schemes share is the fact that it's very hard to pull off combos of any kind, like punch, punch, kick, and special. Again, the reason why is the GameCube controller is not designed to be an arcade controller. I'm not calling this game a bad game. It has its problems, and I just wish they're fixable.